Sydney is on COVID high alert this morning. Two mystery cases identified on the northern beaches and a third sparking fears across the city's southwest.
For more on this, we're joined by infectious diseases expert and advisor to the World Health Organization, Professor Mary Louise McClaws in Sydney. Professor, good morning to you. Two cases on the northern beaches currently have no clear source of infection. Is this a sign, do you think, that COVID has been silently circulating in Sydney?
Good morning, Sylvia. Good morning, Alex. Look, that's one theory, but that would require an awful lot of circulation and all being fairly silent, because it's been about 38 days except for the one case of the cleaner at a quarantine hotel. So that's a long time for cases to go around that are all silent. So that's probably unlikely. One of the other likely possibilities is they know somebody in a high-risk work environment, and they've acquired it from them. And the high-risk work environment includes, of course, hospitals where there may be COVID patients. They may have travelled interstate, although there's very few infections interstate. And then, of course, the other possibility is that they know flight crew that have come home to quarantine at home.
The third infection is that of a man behind the wheel of an airport bus driver. He was basically taking air crews to and from the airport to their accommodation. Right now, crews, they're not required to go to hotel quarantine. They can quarantine at home. Does that need to change?
That needs to change in that we don't want them all to have to go to a quarantine hotel every time their flight comes into Sydney and they're furloughed from flying for a few days. So, of course, the logical thing to do would be to use a rapid point of care test for not just the flight group, but for everybody coming in, and have a test, and if they're negative, they go home, because some of these rapid point of care tests have very high accuracy for a negative test. So if you sent a flight crew home that tested negative, you could be pretty sure they may remain negative. And of course, they could do one on a kit at home to ensure that a few days later they were still negative.
So does that mean that they're likely to throw up false positives?
They could throw up a false positive at about a rate of about 5%, around that rate. Now, that's annoying, because if they do test positive, they've got to stay in the hotel overnight and possibly have a PCR, the gold standard test, to ensure they're okay. But that's a minor inconvenience when you're thinking about sparking clusters in the community.
Professor, you've sent an open letter, haven't you, to the state and federal health departments. You want an overhaul of our airport screening systems. What are the changes that you want to see?
Well, I'd like to see every passenger hopping on a plane to come to Australia to be tested with a rapid test before they hop on the plane. Now, if that can't be done because of logistics, then at least we get them to be tested as soon as they arrive, and then we know who's potentially positive and who's potentially negative. And there's no exception. No embassy staff, no overseas flight crew, no Australian crew who are exempt. No one. They all get tested, because at the moment, people who go into airport quarantine don't get tested until day two. And then by the time the tests come back, that's day three or four. And this way we would know, particularly the flight crews and passengers coming from that high-risk area of Northern Hemisphere at the moment.
Professor, we have three cases in Sydney as we speak. How worried should we be?
We shouldn't be overly worried, because we have one of the best contact tracing teams in the world, and they will be onto it a bit like a rash, so we shouldn't be worried at all. But I really would like to see all of your viewers during this festive season be sensible. If they've come into contact with people, stay at home, go get tested,
wear a
mask in public transport.
Yeah, it's a handy wake-up call, isn't it? Professor, we appreciate your time this morning. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay well.